Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Wrap up to Excel 2010, Chapter 18, Subtotals. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelling. We're working through the Rev Up to Excel 2010. Although, this really isn't new to Excel 2010. Subtotals have been around for a long, long time. A huge, huge time saver, at least going back to Excel 97. So I have a data set here, and I want to add totals by product. Very easy to do using the subtotals command. First thing you want to do is you want to make sure that you sort this data by whatever you're subtotaling. So I sort by the product field, puts all of those products together. And then we want to come to the data tab, out to the outline group, and it's going to go off the screen. This just annoys me. It's right out here where you can't see it. Sorry. So I put it up here on the quick access toolbar. All right, the subtotal dialog box. A few tips here. It always wants the subtotal by the leftmost column. Well, that's hardly ever what you want to do. So make sure to check that. It looks at the rightmost column. If the rightmost column is numeric, then it chooses sum here. Otherwise, you might get a count. If you get a count, you probably want to change it. Now, there's 11 different options there. Sum is the right one in this case, so we're good. And then we choose the numeric fields. If you want every customer on their own page, page break between groups. All right, so we click OK, and bam, just that fast, it went through, and every time that the product changed, it inserted a brand new row. The product name, the word total, and then the totals for that product. An amazing, amazing feature that really could save you a lot of time if you're doing the totals manually. Now, out here on the left-hand side, three new buttons, 1, 2, and 3. We're going to press the number 2 button. It'll collapse everything down and show us just one line per product. The other thing that's really amazing to me and what a lot of people don't know about subtotals is that if we want to see the largest product at the top, when it's collapsed this number 2 view, you can come over here to column F, and we'll click Z to A, the revenue column, and it brought the largest product to the top. But when we go back to the number 3 view, you'll see that it actually brought all of the records along with that total. All right, so it didn't just bring the total along, it actually sorted an entire chunk of records. In this case, about 109 records came to the top, and then the next chunk. It doesn't sort within the group, but it just brings all of those records up to the top. So a fairly cool feature, automatic subtotals. Been out there on the data menu for a long, long time. In the right situation, will save you an immense amount of time. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.